JJ the CPA here, hope you're doing well. So this is the short version. This is the non-coach version. Those of you that are part of the JJ the CPA community, for lack of a better word, you might enjoy the coach one, but I'll tell you this, I do some yelling in it, but on behalf of the employer and some of the frustration that's going on. Now, what am I talking about here? Because this is the short version. Let me just get right to it. Basically, the government's come out, man, they are just going to, they're giving out whoopings, or they're announcing that there are going to be some whoopings coming for those businesses that got this money that somehow they're saying later they're going to determine if you didn't need it, you're going to get a whooping. What? What's that really mean? I don't know, because basically what we're coming out is that you need to reevaluate the uncertainty that you thought you had when you got PPP. Well, there's, in my opinion, there's no real way to figure that out. But here's how they're figuring it out. So here is the way that you're gonna have to make some decisions here, and it comes down to this. If you're not spending the money on your employees, whether you're open or not, you need to get that money back to the government. You need to give it back. You got till May 14th to get it back to them. That's what they're saying. Okay, that's a huge, gigantic indicator to the government that you took the PPP funds incorrectly by not paying employees. And how are they going to know this? Well, at forgiveness time. I mean, you're not really dealing with the banks because it's all going to the SBA. Got a banker that thinks the government's going to buy them all up, and you will just be talking directly to the government. U.S. Treasury, Secret Service, IRS, SBA, FDIC, you pick it. I don't know. Maybe. But by May 14th, you have a decision to make. And I think it's actually pretty simple. If you can't get your employees paid, then you need to return it. Forget about the rent. You just need to return it all. You don't get to return the portion that you think, or 75%, all or nothing. The PPP was given out for employers to pay their employees whether they're working or not, period. You don't get to decide if they get paid or not. If you get PPP funds, you're paying your employees. There's no decision that you get to make here, right? This isn't your money. You've been given money by the government to give to the employees to pay them as they were paid pre-pandemic, okay, wages. So if you got employees that are like, well, I'm making more on unemployment, it's like, well, you know, we're going to both be committing a crime if you keep doing it because I got PPP, I can pay you, I got to pay you whether we're open or not. Gee golly, if you stay on, you're going to risk forfeiting your unemployment benefits, paying them back. I'm in a situation where somehow I'm going to get a whooping that hasn't been defined yet. So, gosh, I appreciate that you're going to make a little more money on unemployment, but this is the government. And if you have an employee that's upset, say, hey, well, guess what? Let me give you some documentation, and I want you to acknowledge here that I've said to you that I can keep paying, and you're refusing it. So you're refusing to be paid. So go ahead and sign that now, okay? And now the employee is cut, severed. They're on their own, because here's what you need to know. That employee is actually still going to get their whooping. They're going to get their whooping because you can't get out of this one. There's nowhere to run. There's nowhere to hide on this one. And what do I mean by that? In 1106E, and you think, oh, well, he's talking technicality, he'll never come up. Whew, you're wrong. In 1106E, you're going to have to produce unemployment filings. Well, I just won't produce them. Yeah. What people got to remember is that it's the government that gave this. It's the government that you file unemployment filings with. It's easy for them to find out. It's a computer program that's programmed to basically go, take this social security number, take this EIN. Were they being paid once upon a time? Yes. Did this EIN get PPP money? Yes. Did this employee continue to get paid? No. Whooping, whooping. Okay, unless you have documentation. But it's not just good enough to have documentation and go, well, you sign this and then we're all good and you can collect this and I'm good at the end. No, No. Then you need to give all the money back. Because you're either paying the employees or you're not. On the couch or not. That's what PPP is. And this seems to be their number one indicator to go, you know what? You shouldn't have got the money because you're not paying your employees. And go ahead and listen to the coach's video, and I'll wrap it up now to just say, you know, if you have employees that are telling you how it is, then listen to the coach's version of this, because I'll pump you up. I'm going to scream a little, like literally scream a couple times to your benefit, to basically give you some, oh, because you are in an impossible situation if you don't take things by the scruff of the neck. You're going to be the one that's getting nailed on this, okay? Now, here's simple, right? If it's simple, well, gosh, am I going to do it wrong now? No. Here's how it is. Here's my business. I had three employees before. I have three employees now. I'm paying the employees whether they're at home or not. It's simple. I have rent. I have utilities. I have an employer match. I have health insurance. I'm paying those things. Simple. Okay, if it comes out exact math, how could it? It can't come out exact. It's like what I've been saying since the beginning. Pay your employees. That's why I've told all my clients, no, you're not letting any of your employees go on unemployment, period, the end. No. So I don't have any clients that have let their employees go on unemployment. None. And you can't either. All right, hey, listen, if you need more, need to be convinced, and if you're not convinced and you think you're getting away with it, FBI just nailed two people yesterday. I want you to think, FBI already arrested, thrown in jail, indicted, headlines, go look it up, okay? And PPP was when? Like, what, 30 days ago? For the FBI to move that quick? What? I'm not saying the FBI doesn't move quick. All I'm saying is, on this? To move that quick? It's easy for them to know these numbers, yo. If you need convincing, pop to the other video. All right, hey, JJ the CPA here. I'd love it if you subscribe, and then don't you ever forget, you've never met a CPA quite like me. All right, hey, love you. Have a great night.